I'd like to tell you, if I may...
Far north. It looks as if the rain should move through fairly swiftly as we go through this evening and tonight, but I think it will become quite slow-moving across England and Wales, and it'll be with us for the next 24 to 36 hours. So a mild night here, but the wind's the main feature of the weather. And into tomorrow, those gales or severe gales lasting in the north of Scotland. But then the westerly wind packing in plenty of showers here, some sleet and snow for the Scottish mountains, and feeling cold too. Whereas in the south for England and Wales, well, we'll be stuck with that slow-moving weather front, giving some heavy pulses of rain at times. And it'll be into Tuesday before this next low develops and gives it a kick out of the way. So with some wet weather to come here in the south as well, followed by more wet weather then on Tuesday. So the first batch will get away, and then we'll see the rest of that rain on the next system spreading right the way across the British Isles. And as the cold air digs in behind, we could see some sleet and some snow as well. So a pretty cold and blustery day with those wintry showers following, some rather prolonged showers, I think, of snow over the Scottish mountains. Those will start to ease on Wednesday, but that's only because we've got some more wet and windy weather to come. The timing's a bit difficult, but it looks as if it'll be during the second half of the day, with eastern parts getting away with a mostly fine spell. Then during Thursday, well, that will clear away, and then the colder air returns with some fairly widespread wintry showers, but
makes it essentially the warmest year on record. It was also the sunniest since 1995, but that was offset by extensive thunderstorms and flooding from weather systems moving across from the west. The wet weather was certainly in evidence during the last month of the century. In Barons Court in Northern Ireland, 250 millimetres, that's around 10 inches of rain falling during the month, more than twice the average, but it also made it the wettest month of the whole century at this location. And it looks like we're going to see a similar theme through the coming week as well. We've had some rain pushing in across Scotland during New Year's Day. And we'll see through the next 4 or 5 days, weather systems developing, deep depressions running up between Scotland and Iceland, bringing strong winds to northern areas, but also pushing those weather fronts out of the Atlantic and across most parts of the British Isles. So most of us, I think, will see some rain from time to time. The rain through Saturday has been mainly across the northwest of Scotland, but it is going to start moving southwards during the course of the night, quite heavy for a time still across parts of central Scotland, fading away as it comes southwards, dry in many places during Sunday, but then the next batch of rain coming in quite quickly, I think, from the west during the latter part of the day. The main problem, though, through the rest of the night is going to be fog, already turning quite widespread across many parts of England and Wales, below 100 metres of visibility in some areas, so certainly some rather tricky conditions out on the road. Some of the thicker fog, I think, across these central areas, where skies are clear over the top, but that narrowing band of clearer skies as the night goes on means that frost should be confined, I think, to those central areas, elsewhere temperatures staying 2 or 3 or even 4 degrees above freezing. Come tomorrow, though, it looks like it's Northern Ireland through into northern parts of England, central and eastern Scotland that'll have the brightest of the weather, those showers across the northwest gradually dying away. But the cloud always tending to hang on, I think, across the bulk of England and Wales, some of that overnight mist and fog as well, rather reluctant to clear away. Where the fog sticks around, temperatures only 4 or 5 degrees. Most places, though, nearer 7 to 9, but quite a mild 10 degrees down on that south coast. Through Monday, another weather front coming southwards, getting stuck across southern areas, so quite wet at times here. The showers across Scotland turning wintry over the high ground. We're not the only place to be seeing the rains, though. Across eastern Europe, through Bulgaria into Romania, just about a month's worth of rain falling in the space of 24 hours. Those showers, though, have been working their way across into the eastern Mediterranean through Sunday and into Monday, and that's no bad thing. Across Cyprus, it's been an exceptionally dry year, less than half the average rainfall here. The reservoirs are looking very dry at the moment, so those showers will certainly be very welcome. Eastern parts of Ethiopia, too, have seen a very dry, wet season, as it were. We're into the real dry season proper now, the rain's having moved away towards the south, so it'll be into the spring before that rain starts to move back towards the north again. That's the weather. Bye-bye for now.
I hate you!
Illuminating one of the most challenging childcare issues of the day.
This is a person with two faces.
BBC One enters the world of the au pair.
What are you doing running away all the time? You can't run away like...
A job that is unregulated.
Go to a good agency who check every little detail.
Unskilled.
My temp is just about to go.
No! You do not pinch me!
And insecure.
I feel really lonely here. Part of my job.
You don't know how to treat a child.
You are here for him!
Au Pairs, a two-part documentary starts Tuesday at 9:30 on BBC One.
I never want her to see me cry.
A bit of drama and a lot of running.
It's like nothing else that we deal with.
No. They're not so cuddly as I thought.
What a buzz. The heat today was just incredible. Mm.
Join Truder and Steve on safari in a brand new series.
It was complete action, wasn't it?
It was very hectic.
Vets in the Wild, Tuesday at 8 on BBC One.
It's been the biggest ever live broadcast in television history, with BBC One at the heart of the global celebration to greet the new millennium. Now relive the best of 2000 today.